Welcome back to Plug and Play EV. I'm Steve, and in this video, we'll be charging for the first time with Circle K. Let's get plugged in. So for some locational context, we are up here at, as far as I know, the only Circle K DC fast charger in the Northeast, at least New England. Certainly no shortage of the brand, but definitely the fast chargers, not a whole bunch, this whole swathe of New England. We're down in Dover, New Hampshire, which is on the southern end, kind of out of the way. I mean, this isn't somewhere you would necessarily come. I-95 runs along the coast here, and then you have to kind of trek off up Route 4, and we're kind of on the border with Maine here. So the border with Massachusetts is further down. We're in the little sliver that goes through the coast of New Hampshire. So not a thoroughfare, but certainly given New Hampshire's dearth of DC fast charging, it's a welcome addition. We have one charger here, which is capable of up to 120 kilowatts. So I haven't actually done anything other than I've had the Circle K app for a little while. So I'm going to pull that up and we will see what we need to do. So they're using a version of the Drives app, or Powered by Drives technology, which is something that EVgo used for a while before updating their app more recently. So that's an out-of-the-box system, it seems, I guess white-labeled to Circle K now. And you can see this Dover, New Hampshire, 120 kilowatts, 40 cents per kilowatt hour. I don't think I've put a payment method in here, so I'll do that, and then we'll get it fired up, see what kind of rate we get. We're right on the nice sweet spot of temperature. That's pretty much exactly where the Ioniq 5's battery wants to be, so we're not going to have any problems on the cold side. So we'll get plugged in, see what we get. Okay, so slightly laborious sign up with multiple address entries, and then obviously you have to pop the payment card in and then activate, but there you go, only really about 5 minutes. And if you do it beforehand, no big deal. So only the one CCS charger, but you do have two plugs, CCS, and I do believe these are dual charging, so you could split down to 60 kilowatts each, I would guess. We're on our own right now, kind of around the side of the Circle K. There's the large forecourt that you saw on the way in, just in the background there, and the entrance to the store, so pretty good. I'm assuming this will be relatively well lit, given all the lights around the parking lot. Let's go and take a look at what we're on here. So you see both CCS1 gives you the fairly simple startup here. You do have to use the app. There's no credit cards, so you'd have to use that if you didn't know that already. I did have the app, so all the same startup process for me. So it wants you to start it first. These are clearly labeled A and B as they are in the app here, so that's friendly. Then it's just that standard. You've seen this swipe to charge before with EVgo, so I'll do that. Power electronics CCS1. Establishing connection. So swipe to charge in the app. Heard behind me firing up. Started no problem. And the maximum here is 120 kilowatts. And there's no one else plugged in, of course, so we'll see what we get. Seems like it's a well-protected screen. Right up to 116, so not too shabby. Take a look in the car. Fairly uneventful. The app is nothing to write home about, and the sign-up process is fairly cumbersome, as they mostly are, but in terms of actual activation, just swipe to start, plug in, and off to the races. Not too much noise, no fuss. Let's see how we progress. Nice. Steady 5 minutes there. Doesn't actually tell you how much has been delivered, at least in this. App's a little bit clunky, as we've come to expect with this kind of out-of-the-box solution. Just kind of clocks, tells us we're charging. You can get back in, you see your duration, but if there is any information that's supposed to be there about power delivered or how much is it's pushing, it's not there. But we do have the car still telling us 117 kilowatts, so it's held that nicely since we began. Okay, so 20% later there, and charging for 10 minutes. Enough time to grow in, grab yourself a coffee. It's the, one of those freshly ground machines that's nice and new, so that works out pretty well. Screen can be kind of hard to see because it's a bit low down. You'd have to crouch a little bit, and then it's got a lot of reflection because it's got that kind of polished bit in front of it. Hopefully that protects it from screen glare, but also makes it a bit tricky to see. But this does tell you, unlike the app, your time charging in the app, but also tells you your power to the first decimal, which is nice, and 20 kilowatt hours delivered. So let's see how responsive the screen is. We'll stop it. Identify yourself through the RFID NFC terminal. Don't really want to do that. So I can probably stop it from the app, but this does tell you, not that intuitive, tells you this is the one you're on, that's okay. Can't stop it because it wants you to identify yourself, but I don't have an RFID. I don't know if that would work with the app. Probably not, because I don't think it's set up for that. But I can jump into the app here, and the same swipe to start bar can be used the other way to the left to stop. You can hear that stops right up, so it's pretty responsive there. Now just still wants that. So no real info there. Looks like it could have RFID and NFC capability if it needed it. You've got a dark mode, let's see if that helps. Takes a little while to switch over. That's maybe, that's a bit more readable. Not much, but not too bad. Can't really do anything from this part, that's why it wants you to direct you to the app first. You can use English or Spanish. And then there's your light mode. Maybe light's better, I don't know. Either way, slightly awkward positioning, but nice clean looking unit. So Circle K charging. If you've watched any of Bjørn Nieland's videos over in Norway, you'll know that this is a common brand for him to stop with. They really did roll out there very quickly. All the way back to what seems like ages ago now, 2015, 2016 and onwards, lots of Circle K charging sessions. So it's a familiar brand over in Scandinavia, the US, although there are certainly Circle K locations around us in Massachusetts, and you see them here and there. This isn't a place that we've been to charge at all. At the time of recording, in the US at least, there are 13 sites for DC fast charging across the country, spread kind of west coast. There's a couple in California, then Colorado, then some more. They seem to be centered down in the kind of southeast of the country along the coast there. And we have this one up in Dover, New Hampshire, which is a little bit of an anomaly, but I hope to see many more of them coming up. There are also a decent amount up in Canada. They are owned by Couche-Tard, so there are some rolling over on the other side of the border there, but a big name in charging across the pond, and one that could potentially make a difference here in the US as well. So as far as this session goes, 120 kilowatts is a nice solid amount. It's obviously about half of what this car can do on its optimal charging sessions. So you maybe wouldn't choose it as a priority, but if you're in this area, there's not tons of stuff in New Hampshire, certainly as you go further north, so this might be a good stopping off point to then go further up into the White Mountains. So lots of potential for Circle K charging, certainly in North America. Have you tried it? Are you down in one of the kind of Carolinas or over in one of the markets that has this? Have you been able to try Circle K? It seems like this site has generally been good. Couple of negative check-ins in the last couple of weeks, but again, it's back up and running, so obviously that's been turned around fairly quickly. And I hope we see many more of them coming up in the future, New Hampshire especially, because it's pretty sparse up here in terms of DC fast charging. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one. Cheers.